Welcome to this special evening. Let us pray. Beloved, this Christmas season, it is our duty and delight to prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angels and to go in heart and mind to Bethlehem to see this thing which has come to pass in the babe lying in a manger. Therefore, let us hear again from Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God. And let us make this house of prayer glad with our carols of praise. But first, because this of all things would rejoice the heart of Jesus, let us pray to God for the needs of the whole world and all God's people. For peace upon the earth, for love and unity within the world, and for goodwill among all peoples. And particularly at this time, let us remember, as Jesus remembered, poor, cold, the hungry, the oppressed, the sick, those that mourn, the lonely, the unloved, the aged, and the little children, and all who know not the love of God. Lastly, tonight may we be filled with hope, for unto us a child is born. Amen.
The first lesson is Genesis 3, verses 8 through 15, and verses 17 through 19. And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" And he said, "I heard the sound of thee in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." God said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten of the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman whom thou gavest to be with me, she gave me fruit of the tree, and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent beguiled me, and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you above all cattle and above all wild animals. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel." And to Adam he said, "Because you have listened to the voice of your wife, and have eaten of the tree of which I commanded you, you shall not eat of it. Cursed is the ground because of you. In toil you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Thorns and thistles it shall bring forth to you, and you shall eat the plants of the field. In the sweat of your face you shall eat bread till you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken, you are dust, and to dust you shall return." Thanks be to God.